And thank you, Secretary Becerra, for being here. It's great to have you back with the committee. And thank you for your continued work and support, both while you were here and as Attorney General of the State of California, and now in your capacity as Secretary of HHS. Secretary, last year we passed the Inflation Reduction Act, and as you heard Ranking Member Neal run through a number of the things that were accomplished, I want to associate myself with his remarks. But as someone like yourself who's been a longtime advocate of lower drug prices through Medicare negotiation, we were pleased to see that the President's budget calls on Congress to build on what we did in the Inflation Reduction Act, which keeps money in seniors' pockets while also making Medicare more solvent. My question, and to give you a time to do this, can you walk us through your agency's progress in implementing the drug cost provisions in the Inflation Reduction Act, and tell us how each provision will continue to deliver for the American public?
Congressman Larson, and thank you for your efforts over the years on these issues as well. Well, today, those who are in need of insulin are getting it for $35 a month or less, and that's something that's saving most Americans several hundred dollars for this year alone. Those same Americans on Medicare now can access a vaccine, whether for the flu, for COVID, for shingles, and I always hear about shingles because apparently that's a pretty expensive vaccine, $100, $200, free now. No out-of-pocket cost for folks on Medicare to access that. That's saving people quite a bit of money. On top of that, we made the announcement that come September, we will announce the first 10 drugs that will be part of that drug price negotiation that will begin. Though the companies that manufacture those drugs will go through the process then of negotiating for the best price for folks on Medicare. And we hope to continue that process because at the end of the day, this is about saving people money. Right now, Americans, as you know, are paying two or three times more for the same drugs that are being sold in other countries, and even if those drugs may have been manufactured here in the U.S.
And so this direct negotiation, seniors have long been anticipating this, et cetera. So it'll be in September that we'll hear. And how many drugs?
There will be 10 drugs, and then the next year it'll be 15 more. Then the year after that we add more, and every year we get to add them. I think in the wisdom, your wisdom, you said, make sure you do it right for the first 10, and then let's keep going from there.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. I greatly appreciate it. And with that, I'll yield back.